guys, how are you doing? Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, depending on where you are in the world and depending on when you get to see this post. Okay, guys, so today is bank holiday Monday in England. Yeah, this is British summertime now, and today is the adult day for carnival. Anytime I meet up with people, they always ask me all the time, oh, well, when I meet up with people, basically, people have been asking me, oh, you didn't go to carnival, or are you going to carnival? Yeah. Carnival is normally 2 days here in London, so there was the one yesterday. Initially, when it started, it used to be the kids' one. The kids used to have a whole day for themselves. That's how it used to be in the beginning. I don't know what it's like now. I don't know what it's like now, guys. But anyway, that's how they used to do it in the beginning. So Sunday's one would be for the kids and bank holiday Monday would be for the adults. So I've been once, guys. I've been once because obviously I wanted to have that experience of going, you know. You know what it's like so that you can say, yeah, I've been. So I went once. Yeah, but coming back was a nightmare. And then coming back was a nightmare. I mean, even getting there was a bit of a struggle as well. So, as somebody who doesn't like stress, as somebody who cannot deal with stress, guys, I just sit myself in the place where I know I can maneuver. Yeah. So I've been to carnival once, and that was it. Just so that I could have that experience, so that I could tell people, yeah, I've been to carnival. I mean, obviously, I'd love to go again. If it was easy for me to do, I would do it because I'm that kind of person. I like things to be easy. I like things to be stress-free. I don't like things to be stressful. Once things are stressful, guys, those of you that are my spotters, you know me very well. Once something is stressful, or once people are stressful, once they start giving me stress, I'm like, sorry, I won't be able to manage this stress. Because it's just not the person that I am. There's some people who live for the drama. There's some people who live for the drama. They feed off that drama. Some people actually need drama in their life because they love adrenaline. You know, they just love getting into it. I don't really talk about, well, I was about to say I don't talk about my relationships, but yeah, I fall off the wagon. Every now and again, I fall off the wagon and I start talking about some joke that I dated. But anyway, let me not even, I am so grown these days, I try not to even, I mean, the people that I went out with, they annoyed me tremendously, obviously. But do you know what? You kind of get to the stage whereby, I've gotten to the stage whereby if they don't poke me, I won't poke them. That's kind of my MO, my modus operandi. That's the kind of person I am. If you don't trouble me, I will not trouble you. But with getting older, I'm even getting to the point where people trouble me and I'm still like, yeah, okay, I can walk away from that. Guys, it's all about getting older. Getting older for me has been a wonderful thing. I have no hang-ups about getting older. I've got no problems with getting older because I have learned so much about myself as a person getting older. And all of the lessons that I have learned in my life, now I start to put them into practice. And if I can just be a little bit more disciplined with myself, guys, I see a lot of improvements in myself, you know, taking the advice that I have learned from other people and actually putting it into practice. I know that I don't have to do things because everybody's doing it. It was never my personality anyway. That's never been my personality. I know I don't have to do... Me, I am not follow up. I'm not that kind of person. Me, I just like to mind my business on my own, JJ. Follow-come is an addendum, isn't it? Follow-come is somebody that decided, okay, let me insert myself and add myself to the proceedings. If I am wrong, I will go and check for the meaning of follow-come. Because some of these slangs, you have to be sure before you use them. But anyway, guys, if you went to the carnival, if you had a great time, congratulations. I'm glad you had a great experience, and I hope you had a great experience. But when you're around there, always remember that people live around there. Because I remember when I went many, many years ago, when I did go, we were hanging around somebody's house, obviously dancing. Because for me, it's all about the dancing and the music. Anytime I go out because I want to dance with people. I have just revealed something to you guys that I've never told you guys before. Anytime that I go out because I want to dance with a lot of people, you know, to dance in company as opposed to just me alone dancing in the flat. That's all I go out. When I say I go out, how long has it been since I even went out? The party that they invited me to, where I was one of the few people that wasn't wearing white. God. When you go through so much in life, guys, when God wants to bless you, he will overwhelm you with his blessings. And I believe the reason why he does that is because, like any loving father, he will take into consideration all of the things that you have been through. So when he decides to bless you, he will be like, blessing upon blessing upon blessing upon blessing upon blessing. Guys, I know that when God decides that he wants to answer me for all of these things that have been happening, I know that I'll be laughing all the time. Guys, you know what it's like when I start laughing? You guys, you know what it's like when I start laughing? I just be laughing all over the place because I'll be so happy. I know that it's gonna happen because that's how God works, guys. He's exciting. When they say that people find God and they become fanatical about God, it's not the case. It's just that the more you know God, the more you want to know him. Like any loving relationship, guys. That is the simplest way for me to put it. Like any loving relationship, guys, the more that you know him is the more that you want to know him. That's why when they say somebody found God, God is never missing. God is never missing. God is everywhere. He is all over the place. He is never ever missing. So don't ever feel that you don't have access to God, because God is everywhere. He's omnipotent, omnipresent. The all-seeing God, the all-feeling God, the all-hearing God. He sees everything. He knows everything. If you call him, even if you call him in jest, he will turn up because he's always there. You know, he's always there. He's everywhere. He's everywhere. So, guys, when you see people falling in love with God, getting into the things of God, you know, wanting to know God more and more, it's because something has happened to them. One way or the other, something has happened to them. Maybe they've had an encounter with him. If you have an encounter with God, nobody has to tell you that you've had an encounter with him. Once you've had an encounter with God, you will know. Nobody would have to tell you you just had an encounter with God. Nobody will have to tell you. When it happens to you, you will know. And do you know what? I really, really do hope in real life that you have an encounter with God. I really do, because it will change your life, and it will change your life for the better. It will be a good change in your life. So, guys, how did I start this conversation? Yeah, today is bank holiday. So even though yesterday when I went out, I spoke to somebody and I was aware of the fact, well, they made me aware of the fact that it was the first day of carnival. somehow it didn't compute in my brain that the bank would be closed. So when I went to the bank, obviously the bank was closed because today is Adults Carnival. So guys, I had to go and pawn my watch because I don't have anybody that I can ask for money, you know, to loan me. Guys, I will tell you guys so that you don't have to go around looking for the information on the streets. I keep on saying it again and again and again and again. You cannot shame me. The reason why you cannot shame me is because I have made a conscious decision not to be ashamed. Yeah, I'm gonna say it again. I'll say it again for anybody who wants to hear it again. You cannot shame me. The reason why you cannot shame me is because I have made a conscious decision not to be ashamed. Yeah? I have made a conscious decision not to be ashamed. Because I know that I am not doing anything that is shameful. So if you're one of the people who's actually trying so hard to put me to shame, you have already failed. The reason why you have already failed is because I have simply refused to be ashamed, regardless of what it is. You cannot shame somebody who has actually decided they're not going to be ashamed. You cannot. So it's up to you. Me, I have made my choice. The choice that I made is to follow my God because I had an encounter with God. You, I hope you get to know that same God that I know, the one who changed my life, the one who protects me, and the one that blesses me. For those of you who think that you can shame me, you might have to go back to school, honestly, because you cannot shame me. You can't. They have tried so hard. They've tried so many things. I refuse to be ashamed. It doesn't matter what you saw about me. I don't care. I don't care what you saw about me. I actually really don't. If I need to go to the shop, I will still go to the shop. Any place that I need to go to, I will still go to. This message is actually really for the people who feel that they can shame me. I keep on telling them, you can try, but you're not going to succeed. Why? Because I am that girl who will still, I will still turn up. I will turn up anywhere. It doesn't matter what you have seen or what you think you saw on the internet. I don't care. If I need to go anywhere, I will still go. And I will go with my full chest. Yeah? That's the kind of person that I am. Why? Because we do whatever it takes to get the job done. That's why you cannot shame us, because we are willing to do whatever it takes to get that job done, as long as I don't have to harm anybody. So that's that. If you're one of my Spartas, if you have been missing my content, you would already know the reason why I haven't done, you know, this kind of content for a long time. You will know. If you're one of my Spartans, you will know the reason why. Because when I'm exhausted and I'll just switch off. Because I don't really want to be putting angry contents out there in the world. I don't want to be doing angry videos. But I just want to send a message to the people who have actually dedicated their life to thinking that they can embarrass me. You cannot embarrass me. If I want to go to Brixton today, I will go to Brixton. If I want to go to Harlesden, I will go to Harlesden. If I want to go to Paris, I will go to... I'm that girl. Anything that I need to do to get the job done, as long as I don't have to hurt somebody, I will. It doesn't matter what they saw. They saw my breasts. They saw my ass. They saw what? What haven't you seen before? I always say to myself, the people who are peeping Toms, they are people who do not get to see women. They don't get to see women often. Yeah? That's why they have to peep. Because they are the kind of people who don't actually get to see women. That's why they have to peep. Anybody who actually gets to see women who is interacting with women would not have to spy on them. You wouldn't, because you'll be seeing them all of the time. Anyway, guys, I'm going to leave it here. I'm going to leave it here because I'm going to go see if I can, you know, get my stuff. But I just wanted to tell you guys, because I always have to tell you guys myself so that you don't have to look for the information on the streets. I always say this. I will speak my own truth so that when I die, they will not say, oh, on that day, this happened. On the other day, that happened. I will speak my truth so that people don't have to make stories about me. T, she said it the best way. Yeah. She said it the best way. She said, if you tell the wrong story about A, she will actually correct you and say, no, actually, this is the way that it happened. She will actually give you the full gist. It's true. That's the kind of person I am. Yeah, that's the kind of person I am. I control my own narrative. I don't want anybody to control my story for me. Yeah? I don't want anybody to control my story for me, especially while I'm still alive. I will tell you, this is the way that it happened. You can always come to the video and check. That's why I do these videos, because I know that one day I will leave this earth and there are people who will wonder. People will wonder, okay, what happened to Anne on this day? Okay, what happened that day? What happened the other time? Why did she do this? Why did she do the other? That's why I come here and I speak to you guys, because I know that even after we're gone, you still have fans even after you're gone. I know that I'm not going to live forever. And I know that there are people who will be interested in these things, just like I'm interested in other people when I see their stories. And I think to myself, I wonder what was going on then. You know, I wonder what was going on then. So guys, me, I will tell you guys the truth myself. Whatever happened, however it happened, I will tell you myself. I will not allow some random people to come and be telling you stories about me. No, while I'm still alive, I give you people the full gist. Yeah, baby, I give you the full gist so that when I leave this earth, the people who want to know, they will know the truth. Yeah, baby. Ain't nobody making up no stories about me. No, sir. So, guys, anyway, if you like this channel, if you like this kind of content, my channel on YouTube is a lifestyle channel. Lifestyle means that I talk about a lot of things, yeah, concerning my lifestyle, concerning the things that I'm interested about. Cake. Something that I'm very, very much interested in. I love cake. This is red velvet. I love cake. I love to eat. It makes me feel good. It makes me feel good. I'm not supporting drugs, because tomorrow now they will say Anne told us to go and take drugs, no? But this is what I will say to you. Eating cake and smoking, some of the things that make me feel good. Yeah, I've said it so many times. Like I said, I will tell you the truth myself. The reason why I smoke is because it makes me feel good and it calms me down. And when there's so much noise where I live, when the noise is too much, I just have to smoke so that I can actually calm down, so that I don't get into altercations with them. You know, so that I'm not sparring with them all day long. Because it's a temptation from the devil. So when they start and they come with the, what do they call it? Skylarking, gaslighting, all those things. If I don't smoke, it is more difficult for me to just ignore them and do what I'm doing. I'm just explaining to you guys. This is a disclaimer that I'm putting here. This is for the people who will say, she's telling us to go and smoke. No, I'm explaining to you. Everything I do, my whole life, I'm always explaining to people, this is why I did this thing. This is why I did that thing. That is why I smoke. Because I am calmer. I am just calmer and I can deal with things easier. Yeah, and that is the reason why, and that's probably one of the reasons why it's harder for me to stop. But it is better for me to smoke than to have a shopping addiction, because before I started smoking, I used to have a shopping addiction. Why? Because when I feel stressed out, I'll go and buy something. I know I'm talking to a lot of people. I'm not the only one. When I'll be stressed out, I'll just go and I'll go and buy a whole heap of stuff that looks shiny and pretty. Obviously, just to calm myself down, not because I needed it. And then I said to myself, I can't be going through this all of the time. Shopping, 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 shopping. I don't even have the space for the stuff. Yeah. You feel good for a second, then it wears off, and then you have to go and buy more stuff. So I said to myself, this therapy, the retail therapy, is not a long-term solution to whatever it is that is bothering me. Because I know that a lot of things are bothering me. We're talking about coping mechanism. That's what we're talking about now. How all of us cope with stress. I cope with my stress by smoking. I used to cope with stress before by eating a lot of cake, eating a lot of things like that. But then I said to myself, no, this is not gonna work for me, because I don't want to be struggling with the weight all of the time, up, down, like I did all through my 20s, my 30s, my early 40s. I'm like, no, this is not something that I want to be dealing with throughout my lifetime. So instead of comforting myself with food, I know a lot of us do that. I am one of those people. I still do it. But I know that I have the kind of body that has the propensity to put on weight. So I said to myself, no. Comforting myself with food, cake, I've got a sweet tooth, confectionery. I said to myself, it's not going to work. It's not going to work. I have to find another way. And that's how I actually started. I mean, I was always smoking, but I wasn't smoking as much as I am now. But guys, all of these things that we're talking about, they're just coping mechanisms. We all know that they're coping mechanisms. Yeah. So for those of you who have ever wondered, why does she smoke so much? Why does she smoke so much? Obviously, if I'm smoking more than I normally do, it's because I'm stressed. I am more stressed than I'm normally stressed. So I'm smoking more. Makes perfect sense, doesn't it? But me, I would actually prefer to stay in that my little crib and smoke and be quiet and then go to bed, listen to music or whatever it is, and then go to bed without having to continuously being a back and forward with all of these people who just love drama. Because some of them, they're just built for drama. They just love drama. They just want to have an argument with you. You could be sitting on your own minding your business. They want to have an argument with you because that's the kind of person they are. Yeah? We have all encountered these kind of people. We all know these kind of people. So guys, let me say it again for the last time. That is the reason why I smoke, because it calms me down, and it just makes it possible for me to just deal with certain situations. Some people are gonna say, "Hey, but you're a prayer warrior, aren't you?" I pray a lot. I do. I pray a lot. But am I a prayer warrior? Because me, when they say so that somebody is prayer warrior, I see these people who were. The way that they are praying, I'm like, whoa, I wish I could pray like that. I wish I could pray like that, but everything is different for every different person. Everybody has different gifts. But I always say, Abba Father, please strengthen my prayer life. Please, Abba Father, strengthen my prayer life. Let me be the kind of person who flows in prayer. let me be the kind of person who actually flows in prayer. Let me know the right prayers to pray. Let me know the right prayer points. Let me actually pray the prayer that connects to Jesus, that connects me to the Holy Spirit, that connects me to the Father, so that I will not be shouting, Abba Father, Lord Yeshua, all the time. So that's what one of the things I always pray. I say, God, teach me how to pray. Teach me how to pray better than I can, so that I can be more connected with you. See? I love Abba Father so much. I love Jesus so much. I do. They don't stress me out. They don't stress me out at all. So, guys, so that the video is not too long, so that I can actually, maybe I'll upload it without putting anything fancy on it. Maybe I'll just upload it without putting any edits on it, without editing it, without making it fancy. Because the true Spartans, they know what it's all about. Anyway, guys, some people were hungry for vlogs, so I've come and I've done a vlog today. I pray to God that next year I do not make the same mistake, because the same thing happened last year as well. I woke up early in the morning to go to HSBC. I prepared myself, you know, me and my little budget. One day I'm gonna have a large budget, guys. Me and my little spending budget. I prepared myself for what I was gonna do, only to go and see the sign, the notice on the bank saying today is bank holiday, the bank is not open. So guys, I hope it doesn't happen again next year. I hope I get myself sorted out. Another thing I was actually gonna update you guys about, job. So after all of the things that happened, you know, after everything, basically, it was nigh impossible for me to actually get a job. God. I was just, guys, I cannot even begin to tell you. There's so much noise in the background because the radio is on in the background, so they will probably copyright this video. I might get a copyright tag, but hey, there's nothing that I can do about that. I have decided I'm just going to do what I'm going to do, and that's it. If they copyright the videos, they copyright the videos. Sometimes it's just too much and it's too many things to deal with, yeah? There's the video that I did in the other place and the radio was on in the background. I think 2, 3, 4 times I've done videos and the radio's on in the background. And then YouTube, when you upload it onto YouTube, they copyright the video because of the noise in the background. There's nothing you can do about that. You can't do anything about whatever's going on in the background, can you? But YouTube will still copyright the video if you upload it. So, hey, guys, I'm going to end the video here. I was actually going to say a bit more, but I can't start struggling with the background noise. It will just be ridiculous. So, guys, I might do a continuation on this video, on this topic, on the things that I was talking about in this topic. If you like these kind of, you know, relational videos where people actually talk to each other, talk to their fans, you know, give updates on what's happening with them, their lifestyle, everything. I was actually going to tell you guys about work, about trying to get back into work, wanting to get back into work. I found it nigh impossible for so many years to get a job, you know. Just whatever these people did, they did their job so well that I was calling people for ages. I would apply, they wouldn't respond, etc., etc., etc. But guys, if you want to hear more about that, please stay tuned for part two when I'll be updating you guys about all of that stuff, yeah? All that has transpired. And right now, I am just praying. I just pray that dictate will say yes. I'm just praying that dictate will say yes, because I know that that's a job that I've done before. That's a job that I'm really competent in. It's a job that I can do remotely, so I could do it from anywhere in the world. And it will work. So guys, I pray that dictates are gonna say yes. Dictates, please say yes. Please say yes. Please give me some dignity. Please give me some dignity in money. Please, God. Let them just say yes, please. So that I don't have to receive the insults, some of the insults that I've been receiving. I know I can work. There was a time I applied for so many jobs and it just got to the point where the last straw was the BBC, really. When they just humiliated me anyway. So whatever, guys. If you like this and if you want to see more of my videos, you want me to talk more to you guys about whatever it is you want me to talk about, just like, comment, subscribe, and it will inspire me to come and do a vlog for you guys. Those of you who are my Spartans, my true Spartans, you know me, you know what I'm all about. So like, comment, subscribe, grow me, thank you very much, grow me, and you will enjoy me. Attack me, you will not enjoy me, just like any other person. Grow me, support me, you will enjoy me. Do the opposite, you won't. That's just it, guys, just like any other person. So 3,000 subscribers, it is possible, it's easy enough to do, guys. Come on, do it.